Hello, everyone. Welcome to the first game of the season. Oh, I'm going to show you my three guys I've traded for. So I traded for Gerrit Cole, Eric Hosmer, and Josh Donaldson. So those are my three players I went for. So everything else is pretty much the same. As you can see, it's all pretty much the same. So, all right. Problem is, I don't have any back people on the bench. Darn it. Well, I forgot to fix up my lineups. God dang it. Alright, hold on, guys. I just try to freaking man. Oops. My goodness. Whoopee. This is I hate doing this. All right, that should be good. All right, try to do that as quick as I could. I normally try to fix my lineups before I start up. All right, here we go. Sonny Gray. All right, we're ready to go. This might be a random question, guys, but do any of you know how to do constructive interference problems in college physics? Because I'm kind of having a tough time a bit. Constructive and destructive.
Afternoon baseball here on the show.
So today, if you have any idea, let me know. Matchup
between the Detroit Tigers and the Yankees. Billy Burns heads for the box, ready to lead this one off today.
Start this up. Detroit,
the center fielder number one, Billy Burns.
Underway at the ballpark this afternoon as the first pitch is in there for strike one. One strike pitch is a fastball high, and that evens things at one.
Well, when it's warm like this, you really have to keep the ball down. Try to keep guys from
right
it
down
the
middle.
It will
splendid.
Absolutely carry. That's two pitches in a row that were elevated.
And a check swing. Yeah, there we go. Breaks the plane as he set down for the first out. At the plate, Addison Russell, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
Holly breaks off a beauty there, nothing in two now. And a fastball.
Nice.
Right by him, and there are two down.
All right. Off to a good start.
Joey Votto gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on.
Joey Votto.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
In there, and he's in control 0-2 now.
Can't hit it, can they?
Up and in here as he had to bend out of danger.
Safe to say, guys don't care much for that location. That'll get you riled up the plate, no doubt.
Darn it.
Chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. Got him swinging.
Oh, wow.
And that will end the inning.
Got all of them. Nice. Well, of course they start you on rushing
Josh
dynamic.
Harrison comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Second baseman, Josh Harrison.
In there, strike one. Hit out towards second. Throw on to first by Cano, and there's the first out of the inning.
Batting second.
Striding into the box, Jonathan Villar. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here 0-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing away, but foul.
Darn it.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. That misses 1-2. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Come on. Good pitch.
Pitch on the way. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Hot shot to third.
Darn
it. Ibe's got it. Throw gets him. Two down.
Batting third.
Josh Donaldson gets his first
cut. Right,
now.
Here we go.
Bases are empty.
Cover boy.
Two away here in the opening frame.
Yeah, nothing doing so far here. He kind of needs to put up a tough bat right here just to make this guy work a little bit.
Throw on to Votto will take care of him at first, and the side is retired. Second inning upcoming here in Florida.
That's terrible.
George Springer makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat because you know he has big-time power.
And now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him.
Well, not close on either of these first two pitches. He's going to have to find the release point quick before he loses the leadoff.
Man.
Too high, and it's 3-0. That's in there, 3-1. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
There we go.
And it's a fly out to start the second, one away.
Batting fifth. Second
so the bases are empty with one man gone. And set to stand in
That's
the fine second
team,
baseman, Robinson Cano. There's a first pitch curveball trying to come back to the outside corner. Didn't get it that time. It's ball one.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now. That's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving it up there like that.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
And even on 3-0, it's no given that he's going to be taken up there. We've seen him go after pitches in this spot before. He's not going to hold back.
And this is taken by Cano for ball four, and he's aboard. Juan Uribe takes his first shot here with a runner at first now and one away. And here is strike one call to the 37-year-old veteran up there. Nothing and one. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Right back, same pitch, also knee high. He wasn't buying that one either. He's going to have to do something now. He's down two strikes.
The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
maybe a good opportunity here to show him a changeup, give him a different look.
Ooh, that was close.
Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. Takes this the other way to right, but he'll barely have to move out there in right as he hauls this one in for the second out. Alex Gordon set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap to give that man on first a chance to score.
And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. And it's quickly 0-2. Swing and a miss.
Nice.
With a fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Tigers lead. A.J. Pollock strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning. Here comes the first pitch. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Grounded to short. Russell's got it. And a good throw gets him one gone.
Batting fifth.
So the base is empty here with one away. And standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit. Ender Inciarte stands in for the first time.
Inciarte.
Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Here's a first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one.
Pretty good speed here coming out of that left-handed batter's box. So it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
All right. Now you've just seen two straight breaking pitches miss away. So as a hitter, you're going to eliminate that pitch. No way does he throw it a third time.
Up and out over the plate, but a called strike. 2-1. And here's a ball hit in the air.
Rebound. Oh, yes.
Ranging into the outfield. But he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
What?
So it just does beat him to the bag.
Oh, what the frig.
Stephen Vogt set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away. First pitch of the at-bat. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, Matt, the pitcher may have thought the runner might be on the move right there, so he slide steps to hang on to him.
Goodness. 0-2 now.
That looked like a swing from a fantasy camp there.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Slider. Good two-strike pitch, but it misses 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think about.
Runner goes. Strike three.
Oh, that was
he
my
get
fault.
The bat off his
darn
shoulders.
It.
Side retired.
What the freak. Darn it.
Paul Covington is into the box as we are all set to begin the third.
Paul Covington.
And that's in there for strike one. You like what you've seen from this guy so far?
I do. I like where he's putting the fastball, and I like the movement he's been getting on both his curveball and changeup. I think he'll do well.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off 1-2.
That's a good spot for that fastball on 0-2. That couldn't have been an easy take.
Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
Batting ninth, catcher Hank Conger.
Hank Conger is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1.
And I think he'll keep riding that pitch until these guys prove they can do something with it.
And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
Another strikeout, please. Come on.
And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Gray into his motion. Here it is on a ball and two strikes. And a swing there and a miss. And another punch out here. Six already. And that's out number two. Billy Burns will get his second shot at it now. He was called out on strikes to open up the ball game.
And remember, they got him on a fastball, so I got to figure they're going to attack him the exact same way.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. That's wide, 2-0.
That's a pitch that you got to stay on top of, or else it'll take off on you just like that one did.
3-0 now.
Oh, come on.
I think he got the pitch he was looking for right there, but not in the right location. So that's a great job of just holding up the swing.
A strike, and it's 3-1. Hit out of play, and it's a full count now. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Detroit. CJ Krohn digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three. Into the windup and the pitch. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Swing and a miss, 1-1.
You can tell he's got sinker on the mind because he definitely undercut that one.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Yeah, and when that pitch starts off outside, it's much easier to get a better view of it and then just lay off.
Here's a fly ball. Well hit. Gordon going back at the track.
Yeah.
And this one is
the guy who's not even starting got my home run. How about that?
So a solo shot here to left center field as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead. And now is Yasiel Puig. As he'll get caught chasing that one there at strike one. That last home run measured out to 405 feet officially. Lifted in the air out towards left center. And that'll get down for a base hit. Josh Harrison will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first.
And he only saw a couple pitches, too. And that's great for the pitcher when you can get an easy leadoff out like that.
Scorched to third.
What?
By Uribe. On Devoto, a double play.
Now batting.
Jonathan Villar stands in. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out.
Yeah, ground out last time, but you know, with his speed, that's kind of a big part of the
line. Shortstop, he's there to make the play, and that ends the inning. Yankees are off, and Addison Russell will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so against a guy who's definitely in a groove out there.
Yeah, he struck Addison out the side his last time through, and they've got to do something to get this guy out of the role that he's been on.
Fastball in there for a called strike. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
We're already at four. Do I hear five strikeouts in a row?
Swing and a miss.
Oh.
Five straight strikeouts now, and there's one gone.
My God, this dynamic difficulty.
Here with the bases empty, and standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer at that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
And this is swung on and missed as they jump ahead of Votto here, 0-2. And he'll continue this roll.
My
he's
goodness.
On. Make it six strikeouts in a row. Gracious, two away. George Springer will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Not able to hold on there as he swings through a pitch in the dirt, and it doesn't look good for him now. Down 0-2.
And there's number eight. One away.
Nope.
Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
A classic strikeout pitch there on 0-2. It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate.
And Ciarte's there. And that's the third out. Nothing across here this half of the inning. On now to the bottom half of it. Dan Straley will come out now and make his first appearance of the spring.
47,
Digging in to try it again, Josh Donaldson. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Chop foul right at home plate at strike one. Now a swing and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. A little bit off the outside, it's 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
Now a swing and a fly ball. Springer on the run.
No, no, no.
And he's retired one away.
Man.
A.J. Pollock stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. First offering on its way. Swing and a liner. This will be foul.
Darn it.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. The 0-1 is a fastball low, and that evens the count at 1-1. Hops this one up, just beyond the infield on the right side.
Dang it.
And Cano will put this one away for out number two.
The first baseman, number
Eric Hosmer, will dig in. He singled his first time around. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. Thought he couldn't lay off there. He offers it a pitch in the dirt, and the count comes even now at 1-1. Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. This is pulled into right. Springer is
dang it.
Put it away to retire the
side. Man, I can't hit anything.
Go 1-2-3. Robinson Cano heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Up and away to start the inning, it's 1-0. 1-1. Boy, that changeup's had him eaten out of his hand.
Oh, and they've been falling all over themselves trying to get it. But you've just got to know that that's not going to be a strike. It looks like it is, but it isn't.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Third baseman number seven.
Juan Uribe stands in for the second time. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat.
And that was one of the hardest hit balls we've had all game, Matt. It's been a pretty feeble effort offensively for his side.
Gray has his target. Here it comes on 1-0. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Tap foul at home plate.
I'll get him.
No runs, no hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the Tigers. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on 1-2. You start it in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect. Turned out to be a good take.
And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches. He's laid off a few pitches like that one. And now he's worked his way back to a 3-2
go.
Pitch. There to make the play is Puig for round number two.
Took a lot of pitches that time. Still got him.
Alex Gordon digs in with his team still looking at a zero in the hit column.
Yeah, they just haven't been able to figure it out yet, but it's still early. We're seeing some pretty good pitching so far in this game.
Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Just a touch outside, 1-2.
Could have been strike.
Tough pitch to lay off there with two strikes. I'm not sure if that was a good take.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Nate Carnes will come on and get some work as he makes his second appearance so far this spring. And it looks like a right-hander's gotten up to throw in the Tiger bullpen. Sends that one out of play for strike one. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Sent on the ground out to second. Cano has it. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
Now batting. Catcher.
Now to the plate, Stephen Vogt. He got called out on strikes his last time through. First pitch coming. Here it is. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. One out, nobody on. Fastball at 94 miles an hour, and it's 1-1.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. And just fire that thing in there.
Now here's a swing and another chance out there at second. Throw gets him, two down.
Now batting.
At the plate, C.J. Krohn. He went deep in his first at bat, and we'll see what he's got in store for us here.
Yeah, he absolutely crushed it earlier, so let's see if he can get into another one in this at bat.
Back goes Springer, but he won't get there.
Look at that.
Just shy of the wall.
Who would have thought C.J. Krohn was going to be my top player?
Boy, a real good effort that time out there in right field. I thought he had a good shot of getting there, but you see the leap comes up just a little short, and that's going to allow this guy to make it up to second here with a double.
In now is Yasiel Puig. Hits it high and deep out to center field. Ranging back is Burns, still going back. But
what
he can't get to this one. It's off the wall.
What was that?
The runner from second crosses the plate. It's a 2-0 ball game.
Boy, back.
Why the heck was
well
he just standing?
Going to get him a run right here. You've got one runner already at second following the double. And he's just going to switch places with him out there as this ball winds up off the wall. And they're getting some good swings right now as they get a run on back-to-back doubles.
Josh Harrison is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. He's set. Here's the 0-1. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two. Some action now in the Tigers' bullpen as they'll get a left-hander and a right-hander up to throw. In under the hands with a fastball, it's 1-2. Has to be thinking strikeout here. Now a bullet foul as the third base coach had to give it the old ole that time.
Still use that line, really? Man, they've
looking
been using
forward
that
the strikeout.
Forever.
Here's the 1-2. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2. Pitch is way outside and he can't even get a glove on it. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch. Here comes the payoff pitch. And now there's ball four as this goes straight to the backstop.
Yes!
And to score is the runner from third.
Yes!
It's a 3-0 game.
Up next,
Jonathan Villar will try things again. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips.
Yeah, he got solid contact on that lineout, but it just didn't work out. In this game, you have to trust your approach. Eventually, it's going to
pay off. Boy.
And that'll get down out there near the wall. Around third and being waved on home. And he is safe.
Nice.
It's now a 4-0 game.
Well, always good to have them speedsters on your team.
Coming back to haunt a pitcher. It seems that it happens almost every time. And this time, it's no different. As he comes all the way around to score on the two-out triple.
Here's the first pitch to him. Josh Donaldson is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike.
And now, as a reliever, you've got to go out and give 100% and focus on the task at hand. Nope. And you can't let the emotion enter the equation or it'll mess up your concentration and things will get even worse.
On the ground to third, Uribe has it.
No.
Go on to first, and an important pitch there as they get. Leading off the inning, Paul Covington, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game, so just chip away, chip away.
And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one.
Anytime you can throw a first pitch strike to about 60% of the batters you've faced or better than that, then you should get pretty good results. And we're in the middle innings in this game, so that's pretty good.
Nice.
And the sixth inning opens with a flyout, one away.
Now batting.
Hank Conger is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking. Striking out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting, and you have to accept that it's going to happen sometimes.
Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2.
And this is part of why he's had a lot of success so far. He's done a lot of work on the edges and stayed out of the middle of the strike zone.
Smoke the other way, high and deep to left. Ranging back is Inciarte.
Yes.
He tracks it down and makes the play to record the
homer
down. Billy Burns will stand in,
and
he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far.
Well, we've been talking about it a lot, but this offense is just getting shut down right now. And we've seen some really fantastic pitching in this one.
Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1. No runs, no hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the Tigers. A little bouncer. Foul ball, strike two. Here's a high pop-up. Hosmer is there for it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over.
Another quick inning.
Drew Hutchison will come on now as he'll start out the bottom of the sixth.
Number 36.
A.J. Pollock will start things out for the Yankees here in their half of the sixth. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Line drive to left. He's there to take it in for the first out.
Dang it.
So one gone in the inning now, and that'll bring in the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. First pitch on its way. Hard liner towards short.
Yes.
And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. He's around first on his way to second now, and he'll cruise into the bag at second with a one-out double.
Now batting. Left fielder.
Ender Inciarte stands into the box. He's 0 for 2 so far in this one. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Here it comes on 1-1. Goes the other way, and this is in the air out to left. And there to take it in is Gordon for out number two. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now.
Up next for the game,
Stephen Vogt will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. Drilled to first.
Dang it.
Fielded by Votto. And he'll step on the bag himself. Kevin Valido is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number seven.
Kevin Valido.
Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Gray gets the sign, coming at him with the 0-1. And here's a ball hit in the air. On the move is Puig. A quick out. Whew. Number one.
Long run.
Now at the plate, Joey Votto. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
And Matt, that was a pretty nasty breaking ball that buckled him last time up. So it'll be interesting to see if they attack him with the breaking ball again here.
Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. Off the plate at 94, 1-2.
Well, you know, if there's anybody in this lineup capable of getting a rally started, this is the guy right here.
A little low, it's 2-2.
Come on. Strike out.
Swing and he pops it up over toward
very
foul territory.
High freaking.
And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
Nice.
Now batting.
George Springer will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far.
Yeah, and he just needs to make a small adjustment and stay through the middle of the ball. Think about hitting the line drive right back up the middle.
Here's a swing and a miss. 1-1. You have to say they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Oh, so
2-2 now with two away and the base is empty.
And I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup play?
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
And this late into his afternoon of work, the longer this at-bat goes.
And he struck him out to retire the side, so he's through seven. Kevin Polito will stay in the ballgame as a new shortstop. Yimi Garcia will get the ball now as he'll take over on the mound to start the home seventh.
Polito.
And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing and one. Lifted in the air to center field. Burns moving to his left. He's got it one away. In now, Yasiel Puig. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
Good bite to the slider, and he takes strike one. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Burns on the run.
Darn it.
And he makes the catch for the second out. Josh Harrison will stand in here. 0-for-2 with a run scored so far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Chop foul right at home plate. Bases are empty here with two men out. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2. Pretty clear the plan is to keep everything away. A swing and a miss.
Darn it.
Retires the side, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. Marcus Semien is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth.
Marcus Semien.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
This is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
Tries to go the other way as this is hit in the air down the right field line. And the move to the pinch hitter will not pan out as that's taken in for the first out. Juan Uribe will dig in now. He's lined out and flied out in two trips.
Been hitting the ball pretty well, though, despite the 0-for so far.
Hit high in the air down the right field line. And this is taken in easily.
In the exact
like
same
that,
spot almost.
To start the eighth inning. Alex Gordon will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
and their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the bat.
And a ball.
Strikeout. Come on, umpire. Freaking heck, man.
This one's a strike. It's 1-1.
Yeah, and that fastball still got some life to it, even over 100 pitches.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Puig has a read on it, and that retires
right.
The side.
Another down side
in order down. The Tigers. Marcus Semien will stay in the ballgame now as he comes on to play second here. Liam Hendricks is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
Swing and a liner, man.
But this is foul near the seat. Set to deliver the 0-1. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
One thing you've got to be aware of as a hitter is he's going to give you a bit of a variety up there. He's got five pitches, and he's going to use all of them.
There we go.
Drilled right back up the middle, and that is by him on into center field. So
fast
good hitting
guy.
On 0-2 nets him a leadoff single.
Third baseman number 20.
Josh Donaldson will stand in now, and he's been kept quiet out of the number three hole, hitless in his three at-bats so far. He's running towards second. Pitch outside.
No!
The throw.
Dang
he
it.
There, and he is out trying to take second. Good throw. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Hit to short. Valido scoops it up. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Center fielder number 11.
A.J. Pollock will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot. 0-3 thus far. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. And he lays off for ball one. And he takes a called strike
two.
Two out, nobody on. The short hit hard. Valido takes it in. Throw goes to Votto over
at
first. It's in time to retire the side.
All right, let's finish this up.
Yanks held in. Striding in to start the ninth, Paul Covington, and they'll need him to get something going here.
And so far in this one, they're still getting shut out, so this leadoff at bat could be huge if he can just get on base, because they've been held in check all game.
Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. Ball one. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. Change up, call the strike, and he comes back even at 2-2. Now a swing of the ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And taken in out there for the first out.
Now batting.
Hank Conger will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs.
Yeah, and you just can't worry about the score right here. You just got to be able to string together a couple of base runners and take it one pitch at a time, one runner at a time.
And he falls behind 0-2. Struck him out. So now just one man stands
one
between
more.
He and his no-hitter. Billy Burns will stand in now as he is the last man to stand in the way of possible history here this afternoon. And he misses inside with that one. Ball one. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. No
Bang
offer
it.
On that one. Two balls and a strike.
Count is 2-1.
Ooh.
Chop foul over towards the dugout. Mm.
Oh.
3-2.
And a good job here of making him throw a lot of pitches.
He probably doesn't have a whole lot left in the tank, so the more you make him work, the better your chances of getting a mistake.
Good battle, oh, count remains full. Another one sent foul.
Dang it!
Not quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one.
Swing and a
yes!
miss, and he's got it.
Yes! That was it. I know that was on low difficulty, but still. Freaking no hitter, baby.
Performances that I've ever witnessed, and he puts his name into the record books with that no hitter.
And that's why you don't start me on low difficulty. How dare they? How dare they do that to me? Especially with a good pitcher like Sonny Gray.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching
performance.
If I wouldn't
have had that one walk, I would have had perfect. All right. Good first game.
Well, after
get
a
no-hitter,
hitter,
baby.
There's not a whole lot of debate as to the identity of our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, really a dominating performance out there. Look at all the strikeouts. I mean, they just couldn't touch it.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew,
there
I'm Matt Vaskirjan.
First
You've been watching MLB
way.
The Show. For more, get those smartphones.